When we say the Nissan 3.5-liter engine, we immediately mean the VQ35DE model. There were two other modifications based on this model, but this V6 legend has been in production since the year 2000, and there have been literally millions of these engines made in the world for Nissan and Infiniti vehicles. Also, Samsung and Renault car brands used this engine in several premium line car models. So the engine was engineered at the time when Japanese companies were on the rise and were investing heavily to compete with each other. It was the engine that was made to last. The shafts are driven by a good and long-lasting chain, the variable valve timing is used only in the intake camshaft and doesn't cause many problems, pistons are molybdenum coated to reduce friction. All friction surfaces are mirror polished. Of course, the engine wasn't particularly fuel efficient due to its capacity and V6 construction. I will focus on problems that are common for the 3.5-liter V6 Nissan engine, but you should understand that you will most likely have these problems at very high mileage. First of all, these engines are known for oil consumption. Things get especially bad when the car is driven a lot in the city traffic. The problem is that due to low RPM settings, the engine gets a lot of carbon contamination and oil starts leaking inside, burning in the combustion chamber. One more common problem is the catalytic converter, which is located too close to the exhaust manifold. When the converter starts falling apart, some ceramic elements may get inside the engine and scratch the surfaces of the blocks. Unfortunately, there are no symptoms that can help you prevent this. Once you get the converter code and check engine light, you shouldn't ignore the problem. There are several cardboard gaskets under the oil passages, and experienced Nissan mechanics know that they require regular replacement. Otherwise, they will start leaking oil and you will get several specific codes telling you about phaser issues. If the problem is ignored, the engine may get oil starvation problems and be damaged pretty heavily. The coolant system is not perfect, and this leads to local overheating of the 5th and 6th cylinders. There are tons of videos and manuals on how you can improve the cooling system. This is especially important for engines that are used aggressively or are driven at high speeds a lot. Also, there are no hydraulic lifters in this engine, so once every 40 to 60,000 miles, you will need to have the valves adjusted. Other than that, these engines are almost perfect. They can easily last up to 250, 300,000 miles or 400, 500,000 kilometers. Also, the engine can be rebuilt and used even more than that. They have the potential for power tuning and can potentially withstand much more than the original power.